excited. And I wore spectacles since I was about 11 years old. So that's about 59 years I've been wearing spectacles. In most of that time, it seems to me it's made very little difference for things I could do and not do. I stopped playing rugby when I was at intermediate school because I couldn't see the ball without my spectacles. But apart from that, I'm not aware that I've been missing out on anything because of my sight. On more than one occasion, I have experienced an accident and my spectacles have been knocked off. And that can be alarming. There is the shock of the encounter, but then there's the confusion that just because you're suddenly being unable to see clearly. And I've been known to say some very unchristian things when that's happened. So I know what it's like to be optically challenged. It's not the same as being blind, but I think it's relative. Today's gospel reading is the story of Bartimaeus, the blind beggar, who Jesus encountered at the northern gate of Jericho when he was on his way to Jerusalem. For Jesus, the end of the road was not far away. Jericho is only about 24 kilometres from Jerusalem. The main road ran right through Jericho, and Jesus was on his way to the Passover, to observe the Passover in Jerusalem. Now, when a distinguished rabbi or a teacher was on such a journey, it was common for him to be surrounded by a crowd of people, of disciples and followers and learners. They listened to him as he walked. So he was teaching as he was walking. And this is one of the commonest ways in those days of teaching. Now, it was a Jewish law that every male Jew over 12 years of age who lived within 24 kilometers of Jerusalem must attend the Passover. But you must realize that it was impossible that this law should be fully complied with and for everyone to go to Jerusalem. So those who are unable to go often lined the streets of the towns and the villages where these pilgrims passed through and they were wishing wishes on their journey. And in Jericho was probably a lot of local people who were interested in this young man, this young Galilean, who was challenging the religion of the day. He was challenging the religious authorities of the day. Now, the temple in Jerusalem had an enormous number of priests. William Barclay states that there were over 20,000 priests and probably as many Levites. I find that very hard to believe. But regardless of it, it's obviously it was a very good industry. It was a big industry. It blew a lot of people. And obviously they could not serve there all at the same time. They were divided into 26 courses and they served in rotation. And many of these priests and Levites lived in Jericho when they were not on duty. And there was probably many of them in the crowd on that day that Jesus passed through the town. At the Passover, they actually were all on duty. It was one of those rare occasions when they were all needed. But many of them would not start the travel at the time Jesus was passing through Jericho. So it's probably many in the crowd on that day who viewed Jesus with suspicion. If what Jesus said was correct, their temple worship was irrelevant. So at the northern gate to Jericho sat the blind beggar Bartimaeus. He could hear the tramp of many feet, and he asked what was happening and was told that Jesus was passing. And he created such an uproar, to attract Jesus' attention. And the uproar was annoying those who were listening to Jesus' teaching. They tried to silence realise the sort of kingdom